Minecraft is the game of ultimate flexibility. So why is it so hard to get my pet, my actual pet, into the game? But how to get an animal that looks exactly like your pet into Minecraft? In order to do this, we are going to be making our very own custom resource pack. And the reason that I like this technique is because it's very, very flexible. So you can actually go in there and make a texture that looks exactly like your animal, and it will work for you. It will not necessarily work for other people on servers unless you force them on the server to download your resource pack, but it means that you can really change the game however you want. This is a tool that we will be using, NovaSkin. The reason we're using NovaSkin and not any other type of editor, there's lots of skin editors out there, is because we specifically want to be able to change the textures for mobs, because you obviously want your pets, not an actual player skin. So here at NovaSkin, normally you'll start off here, where if you just go to NovaSkin, you know, .me, this is what you're going to be looking at. This is a player skin editor. But over here in the top, you have gallery, wallpaper, resource packs. We're actually going to be working in the resource packs area, but let's start off in the gallery area because this is where you can dig down. So over here on the side, you got ocelots and wolves, and those are really the two types of pets that are easy to get in Minecraft at the moment. NovaSkin does not have the option to edit parrots. So let's start off with cats, okay? So we're gonna look at the ocelot, and you could start off just by looking for a cat that somebody else has already made that looks similar to your cat. So if there is, you know, a version of a cat that you're like, oh my gosh, this is really more just like the Siamese cat. But if you see a cat, there you go, snow cat. This is like, oh my gosh, there's my cat, found it. Wonderful, we're finished, we're done. Well, then you can use this as a starting place. So now we're gonna jump from this gallery area to the resource pack area. So go ahead and head on over to the side of the website, the upper right-hand side, and then choose resource packs, and it'll bring you to a new area of the site. Here, you can make your very own resource packs, and that is what we're gonna do. First, head on over here to this projects, and we're gonna be using the local area. So once we click that, it looks like there's nothing there. We are in that local area. You're gonna create a new resource pack project for you to work with. So we're gonna click new up here, and we're gonna name this. Make sure you name it without any spaces, because apparently spaces screws everything up, and it won't work. So we're gonna just name this my, and then we're going to use underscore instead of a space, and then we're going to say pets. There we go. The author, this would be OMG Chad. Create a new project with local storage. The first time I do this, in fact, I'm going to copy this. The first time you do this, it's going to fail because your browser up here needs to store information directly on your computer. So it's going to fail, and you're going to have to click allow and then redo that again. So rename it my pets, OMG Chad, and then create new project with local storage. And now you see that it shows that we had this error from before, so we can clear that out. So this is your project. Currently, there is nothing in it. This is all, you know, exactly the same as default, basically. Now that you've done that, we can move out of that project area, and we have a few different options to start editing. We're gonna choose entities. Then you can see this is really all the entities in the game. This is great for us. And you have the ones that we're gonna be playing around in are wolves and cats. So let's start off with the cats area. Now you'll notice that this only has 4 cats, and the current game has a lot more. This just hasn't been updated yet. Now you can add all of those cats that are in the current version of the game. Just look for what they're named in their resource pack files, and you can add that new texture, and then that will be the new texture that is in the game when you load up this resource pack. Now that I have my project going, I'm gonna go find a cat that looks similar to my cat. So we're gonna get out of this area. We're just gonna click that banner up there, and we're gonna go back to the gallery. We're going to find a cat. You know what? This cat actually looks very similar to my cat, Waffles. It's a little bit lighter than it should be, but it's very, very similar. So now I'm just gonna click Save to Project. I'm gonna click that, and you can see My Pets is one of the project options. So we're gonna choose that, And, you know, I know that there is another type of cat, so we're going to rename this. So over here, I have all the different names of the cats that are currently in the version. So let's just go for Calico right here. So we're going to take this Calico, and in this third option down here, I've added assets, Minecraft textures, entity cat, slash, and we're going to rename that to calico.png. So we're going to go ahead and hit save. Although this is not a calico cat, it will replace the calico texture in the game. So we're going to do that so that we will have that inside of our resource pack. So now we can open up our resource pack. We can go, you can notice that we're like already a little bit in. So we're going to go assets, Minecraft textures, entity cat. And then we have the new calico cat. So this is going to be replacing the calico cat whenever we load up our resource pack. Now let's do a dog. Now there's a little bit of a downside when it comes to the wolves and dogs in Minecraft, and that is that there is only one texture for a tamed wolf in Minecraft. That means that you're only ever going to have one dog new texture. Currently, luckily, I only have one dog, so this is gonna be great for me. But let's also show off a little bit of the editing tools. So we learned how to take a texture whole cloth, just take it from somebody who had already made it. Now let's make one ourselves. And so let's take a quick look at the editor here. By clicking anywhere off to the side of the animal, we can drag it around. If we hold down shift while we do that, we can move it laterally or horizontally so that if maybe this pane gets in the way over here, then you can move it so that it isn't in the way. And if you want to edit anything, you have a whole bunch of different colors down here. If you click on a color, this is sort of like an inspector window. The inspector will show that, and so you could move it around. You could choose a different hue. You have hue, saturation, and vibrance right there. And then you have RGB, and then you have, you know, alpha, which I think is alpha. You can change up how the colors look down here. You also have an option. So you can see this line goes from one color to another color when I apply that. And it's not going to apply that over two different objects. But the way to change that is you have one color next to the bucket and one color past the ellipse tool. And if you change those two colors, then your line color will change as well. So you can see that would change just like that if you wanted to have that. Now, I don't like what I'm doing, so I'm going to hit undo, 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 and we'll get back to the base here. You'll notice that there is a transparent area for my wolf, and that is because there is a collar that goes around there, the colored collar, and so there's no need to have any texture right there because that is going to be taken over by the collar. If I want to get into editing this, I do know that my dog has some tan ears, so we're going to switch over to this color, and we're just going to add some tan ears. You'll notice that it's editing all the ears independently. We're gonna change up the color just so that it looks a little bit different and so that it's not quite so much the same. And we could also just do that over here in there. And now that looks a little better. Oh, we've forgotten that. Now, if anytime you get to a texture and you're like, well, I know that there's a bottom texture to this, but I can't quite reach it currently because this head is in the way. Or maybe you're trying to edit the tail, and well, the tail is inside the body. How do I reach that? You can right click and then it will select. It will basically solo that thing that you're wanting to edit. So over here on the ears, I can right click those ears a few times and then I get to this bottom texture, and luckily it's easy to reach. I don't even think that bottom texture ever shows up. So now you can edit around your dog and you can have a real fun time just making sure that he looks exactly how your dog looks. Also, you have layers. So I've actually gone through the process and I've made the perfect dog. This looks exactly like my dog, Charlie. There are also layers. So over here, this inspector has a whole bunch of different options. So you could, you know, switch between all these different things. One of them is layers. So you can hit plus and add a new layer. So if that way you're working on something that you're afraid you might mess up the whole project and you want to keep it a little separate. So you're like, okay, I'm just going to go crazy. We're going to add a whole bunch of color. Oh my gosh, I hate that. Well, you can turn off that layer and then that will not apply to the rest of the model. So that's a nice way to change that. You can also open up a new image. So with this dog specifically, I know that I've already done the work to make a perfect texture for my dog. Or maybe you see another texture that you really like, but you only like elements of it, and you only want to incorporate elements. So right next to the plus is this open button. This will open up a file on your computer. So make sure you download the texture that you want to add as a new layer. So I'm just going to upload that, and there you go. So now you can see this tamewolf.jpg image. This is perfect. This is my dog. I've completely changed him all the way up, and you can kind of do this before and after thing, where before, after, my dog looks totally different than the tamed wolf. So now that I'm really happy with this, I can click save, and you can either share this to the open, you know, public. You can save it to your resource packs, which is what we're gonna do. You could download it, or you could save it as a picture based off of where your current dog is, like how he's posed right now. So if we click save, that's not working right now, but that's no big deal. We're gonna go ahead and choose save and choose the resource pack, and we want this to be Tame Wolf. We're not gonna do this crazy stuff where we change the name. We're just gonna use tamewolf.jpg and click save. And now we can go back to our project and look at this, go in here, pets, entity, we have cat and wolf. Wolf will be the tamewolf.jpg, and then back here on the cat is the calico cat. So once we are happy with all the different texture changes, maybe we have more pets that we wanna add, more cats, hopefully, because we don't have any more textures for wolves, then you can go ahead and download this. So we're gonna click download zip, and you'll see that it just downloaded mypets.zip. You take this and you put that in your resource packs folder inside of .minecraft. So here we are in my .minecraft folder. Go ahead and head into resource packs. There we go. Go ahead and grab the mypets.zip, place it into the resource packs area. It's going to copy over and it's going to show up. Now we can open up Minecraft. So first with the cats. Now remember that there are lots of different textures for cats. So let's see if we can get ours. Oh wait, I'm so silly. I didn't actually add the resource pack. Resource pack. There you go. You can see this mypets.zip. Now it is red because it says it's incompatible. It will still work. It's just if you actually want to change this, you just need to change the pack type from 3 to 4. It'll work just fine. So we're going to hit done and load that up. And there we go. Look, that's the cat I added. I saw that calico. I was like, uh-oh, I think I messed up. It's because I didn't have it added. But this is the extra texture that I added to the game. So there we go. Now we have that cute little calico cat. We can get some fish and tame it. Yay! I have a pet. Pet kitty cat. Yay! Let's get away from all these other cats because they're really loud. There happens to be a wolf right here. So if I just tame him. Ah! He's Charlie! He turned into Charlie. Nice! Oh my gosh. So there you go. That is my puppy, my dog, in Minecraft. You can see that I added his little leg. He has little spots on his legs, little brown spots. He has some little pink stuff next to his face, and he has all of that little brownness on his head. So now we have both my kitty cat and my doggy in Minecraft. Y'all are both great. I don't own a donkey. Get out of here. Get out of here, donkey. Stay away from my animals. So that is how you would get your pets into Minecraft. I hope that you have found this video entertaining and useful to you. If you do, awesome. Thanks so much for watching this episode of OMG Craft. If you enjoyed it, please give this video a big old thumbs up. Also, make sure you subscribe for future videos, tips, tricks, tutorials, and spotlights here on OMG Craft. I'll see you next time. Bye.